Hi, in this video, we'll look at how to import fire departments. I would suggest first looking at the videos for importing an incident and reading the import log files, since the import process for incidents and fire departments is basically the same. Right now, let's do a fire department import. First, click Fire Departments in the top navigation bar, then click Import Fire Departments. On this form, you can choose fire department files and upload them. You will receive a confirmation email at this email address when the import is done. If this email address isn't correct, you can modify it. To start, I'll click the Choose File button to open my system file picker, then I'll navigate to my fire department import file and choose it. Make sure the chosen file follows the guidelines on the right, otherwise the system won't accept the file. Lastly, you can click the Yes button next to the Overwrite Existing Fire Departments field. This will overwrite any existing fire departments in the system with the ones in your import file. When you're all done, click the Import Files button to begin the import process. You should see a success message at the top, and it should say that your request has been placed in the queue for processing. This means your request is still being processed. Once the import is done, you will receive an email that looks like this. It should contain a link to download the results of the import. Go ahead and visit that link. It should download a zip file to your system. And that's it when it comes to importing fire departments. In another video, we'll look at how to read the import log files from the downloaded zip file. That video will talk about incidents instead of fire departments, but the process is the same. The biggest difference is that the result zip file that you get after importing a fire department will say fire department instead of incident. In this video, we took a brief look into importing fire departments into the system.